Okay, so as far as pen testing and Android devices are concerned, again, this is going to change based off of the version of Android that you're running. Whether it's as the recording of this course, Nugget is about to come out, or excuse me, Nougat is about to come out. Marshmallow is probably one of the more popular ones out there, as well as Lollipop. And just talking about these things get me hungry. Curse you, Android. But we're going to start off by first going through and looking at the platform itself and seeing if we can root the device. And the reason why we see if we can root the device is because a lot of the malware and viruses and trojans that are out there, the first thing they do is attempt to root the device so that they can have full access. In fact, one of the biggest mobile trojans that's happening right now is the recording of this course is called Hummer, and they predict that it's actually infecting 63,000 devices daily in China alone. And what it does is when it gets on the machine, or excuse me, when it gets on the device, it just proceeds to root the phone to gain administrative privileges, which makes it very difficult then to get rid of this particular piece of malware. And what it does is it starts to install applications that they get kickbacks on, and the developer makes about 50 cents. So the calculations they showed in that article that I read, they make about $500,000 a day or $15 million per month. I don't need to steal your identity. I just need to gain access to your device to force you to run my programs. So that's the first step, is we're going to check to see if we can root it. The second thing is we're going to go through and maybe install a neat little tool called Andoist, which basically does a denial of service attack on the actual device to see if maybe it's vulnerable to a DOS, as well as if any other vulnerabilities pop up. Another thing we can do is actually open up the browser or check the Android browser to see if there's any vulnerabilities associated to it. See if we're able to implement a cross-application script. If it's present in the Android browser, it could allow an attacker to just simply hack the device and try to break down the web browser's sandboxed environment and infect the rest of the machine or the device via JavaScript. And of course, as we talked about in our mobile course, if you didn't take that, you need to go back and, trust me, watch it, because some of the things we talk about is the fact that there is a database on these devices, especially when it comes to Android. Apple has them too. It's called SQLite. So we need to check for vulnerabilities for SQLite. Determine whether or not the email password is stored in plain text in the database. Also check if Skype on Android is using the unencrypted SQL database. That way there I can, pull off things like contacts and profile information. Also see if it's susceptible to any type of SQL injection attack. The next step would be then to check for vulnerabilities in the intents of the Android operating system. What we mean by this is we're going to check to see if we have an application. Maybe I've got this cool little application that tracks my, I don't know, chemicals in my swimming pool, and it has the ability to send an email. Well, it makes a call to my email program. So we can use tools like Comdroid to detect any application communication vulnerabilities. Again, the concept here is that with malformed intents, an attacker could get information such as your private contact information, or read your text messages, or record phone calls, all kinds of fun things. Next, we want to go through and try to check for any leaks in the Android devices using a product called Woodpecker. And hopefully you're all trying to do the Woody the Woodpecker laugh. Now, this particular product goes through and looks for any holes in how the permission-based security model is enforced on your Android devices. And they're called links, which are basically vulnerabilities that allow new and existing applications, sometimes mischievous or malicious, to eavesdrop in on calls, users' location, install applications, send SMS messages, basically anything that you normally do with your phone that you don't want somebody else doing, which could actually lead to you wanting somebody to place a woodpecker on your head for being so stupid.